Hello everybody, good Erev Shabbos, it's Rabbi Rosenstein here. Just wanted to give you a view here of remote from the forest. Baruch Hashem, things here are quiet and peaceful. And I wanted to just take a minute or two and speak to you about the situation here. And just check in with you. A lot of you have sent emails, of support and asking how we're doing over here and how things are. So I wanted to just address that. It's interesting, this is like the fourth time I'm trying to record this year, this week. Each time I tried to record it and different things happened. I tried to record once showing you a view of the streets of Yerushalayim. I had to go into town one day to go to a doctor's appointment with my daughter. And I wanted you to see, people asking what's it like over here? How's life over here? And I wanted you to see that things are going on really, Baruch Hashem, in Yerushalayim and in most of Eretz Yisrael, things are going on, Baruch Hashem, as usual. We're living really with Nisim, which I want to speak about in a second also. At the same time, as you probably have heard last night, I'm speaking to you now, Erev Shabbos, it's early in the morning now, Friday morning. Last night they started the ground invasion, which means that troops actually went in. Until now they've just been, bombing from the air. Now troops have actually gone in, Israeli troops have gone into Gaza in order to try to find a series of tunnels that the terrorists have been using to get into Eretz Yisrael, which again, Baruch Hashem, the shmira that Hashem has been giving to Klal Yisrael during this past week and a half is something quite unbelievable. And that's really one of the main things I wanted to speak about now. I people ask how we're doing over here and how are we? Is it tense? Are we nervous? I could just tell you, for me personally, the overwhelming feeling that I feel from this is a sense of achrayus, a sense of responsibility. People say all the time, if I would see open miracles, if I would see, Nisim, so then I would have emuna, then I would, I don't know what else you could call this. Anybody who's looking at the situation over here, there's over 1,300 rockets have been fired. Unfortunately, there have been people who have died. One person was killed on the border a few days ago from a mortar. There was a woman here in Yerushalayim who had a heart attack. Matzei Shabbos, a woman who was visiting from America. There's another person who was Nebuch hit by a car while he was running for cover. It's not that we have not been suffering at all. But relative to the amount of suffering that our enemies have been trying to inflict upon us, it's mamish a miraculous situation that we're living with over here. I'm sure you've heard of the Iron Dome, Kipata Barzel. The Iron Dome, but it's all Hashgacha, it's all Siyata Deshmaya, it's all Hashem. I learned with a person, a Chavrusa in the morning over here, who's an Israeli person, who's a Baal Tshuva, and he told me that a friend of his is somebody who actually worked on the Kipata Barzel, actually worked on the Iron Dome, as an engineer who also became a Baal Tshuva. And he said to his friend, you guys must be so proud of this piece of equipment. And he said, there are definitely people who feel that way. He said, but if you ask me, he said, I see that this is all Nisim. He said, if you knew the amount of things that could go wrong with every single one of those launches, the fact that it is having the success rate that it has is something that's unheard of, is that it's mamish min hashamayim. Not only that, I don't know what they report in the news in America, but again, I just feel this is a way to just to Hashem to show us, his protection, that we shouldn't have any questions about it or think it's just, mikre, think it's just, happenstance, it just happens to be this way. But the Palestinians, this is like a shocking thing. They've inflicted more damage, both in terms of lives lost and in terms of infrastructure to the Gaza Strip, than they have to Israel. And I don't mean in terms of bringing Israeli airstrikes, etc. But one rocket went off and hit Gaza itself and killed seven people, Palestinians, which first of all, also, I just want to say also, I think it's important that Klal Yisrael are suffering, but there are also Palestinian people that are suffering that I'm sure are not share the view and the vision of Hamas. Those that do, so they deserve the situation that they're in if they are out for our destruction. There are people that are suffering also that I think we have to feel bad for as well. So seven Palestinians were killed, and in 2 days in a row, again, I don't know what they reported in the news, 2 days in a row, Palestinian rockets hit power lines. Yeah, power cables that bring electricity to Gaza. So 2 days in a row, one on Sunday and the next on Tuesday. So 20% of the electricity is lacking now to Gaza because of their own rockets hitting their own infrastructure. And 1,300 of them more have been fired at Eretz Yisrael. And yes, it's unnerving. And yes, it affects people and they have to run to the bomb shelters. But the shmira that we're getting from Hashem, there's a story after story after story, just missing here, just missing there. And it's something, again, I feel a tremendous sense of achrayus, a tremendous sense of responsibility, which I really wanted to share with you. that Hashem is, we're living through Nisan, we're living through miracles over here, and we're experiencing protection and a sense of calm here that I feel like a miraculous bubble that I wanted to, again, just to share the idea with you and to tell you, we all have an achrayus to daven, you know, all the chasadim that Hashem is doing, you know, when we say brachos, sagomel chasadim tovim la'amo Yisrael, to have in mind that Hashem is protecting us all the time, and now Hashem, you know, should protect our troops as well who went into Gaza. I just want to share two other thoughts. One, just on the parsha, there's an interesting thing that I think is very relevant to the situation that we're in. In the parsha this week, Hashem tells Moshe Rabbeinu to tell Klal Yisrael to destroy Midian, to go in and fight against the Midianim for their attacking Klal Yisrael. They attacked us spiritually. Their women came and seduced our men. And Hashem tells Moshe to destroy them. So when they go out to war, the generals go out to war and they kill all the men, but they don't kill the women. And the Mefarshim, Rav Moshe David Vali, and others point out that this is a curious thing, because you'd think that the women were the ones who did the Aveira, right? The women were the ones who brought the Jewish men into the Aveira. They should really be the ones who were punished. But the generals who went out to war saw that it was really the men who were pushing the women to do this. It was really the men who were sending out their women, like we know the story by Cosby, Basur, right? The woman who was with Zimri, that, you know, the king himself sent his own daughter to go do this. So the men were really held accountable. When they came back, Moshe Rabbeinu said, no, the women also have to die. The women who were involved in this spiritual attack on Klal Yisrael also have to die. But the other people, the people who were not involved, or the women that were not old enough to be involved, etc., and the children, so that the Torah says that they should be spared, and they don't deserve to be killed. So I was just thinking, you know, it's similar to the situation that we have now. It's such a complicated battle situation where you have people going in, and you have different types of people there in the territories. You've got, Rishayim Gemurim, members of Hamas, Islamic Jihad, these people who are literally out to kill you and me and every man, woman, and child in Klal Yisrael. There's no question about it. Those people are rodfim. They have a din of a rodef, a din of a person who is chasing. We have a mitzvah to kill them. It's a mitzvah to go in and kill them. Not only that, but the halach is clear. Anybody who helps a rodef, anybody who is helping a rodef to go ahead and try to kill somebody else, so there's a mitzvah also that they are a mitzvah to eradicate as well, because they are helping others kill. The people beyond that, people who are neutral, people who are not involved in helping and not involved in any active thing. So that's like, the children of the pot, those are people that they don't have a halacha, they can't be killed, chas v'shalom, indiscriminately, and like this terrible kidnapping of the Palestinian boy that was done, there's absolutely no justification for that whatsoever. The question that comes up in a situation like we have nowadays, unfortunately, is a question of collateral damage. It's a question of people who are dying, who really don't, are not involved in this conflict, but in order to get to the rodef, in order to get to the person who's trying to kill me, so there are other people who have to die as a result. That's something in halacha which is permissible to do. There are many different cases, I'm giving a whole shiur on this now, many different cases in halacha where we see that even a rodef who has no intention to be a rodef, but if a person is preventing somebody else from being saved, so that person has a halacha of a rodef also. So it's unfortunate, but if there's a person who is an innocent bystander, but in order to kill the rodef, this innocent bystander has to be killed in the process as well. So it is permissible to do that. And unfortunately, that's what's happening, a lot nowadays. The last thing I just want to finish up with, I didn't have a chance. Like I told you, I tried 3 or 4 times this week to post the shiur on the 3 weeks. So I just want to go quickly, a very brief overview of the halachos. The 3 weeks began with Shavasar Batamuz. It's a time of mourning for Klal Yisrael. Number one, we don't get married during this time. Number two, there's no music or dancing. If you're listening to music for exercise, it's mutter. If you're using, music to to help you keep pace while you're jogging or something, it's mutter. If a person really, really needs to listen to music, the poskim say to listen to slow music or classical music. Me'ikar adin is mutter, but it's really better to avoid if a person can avoid it. I don't really hold there's a difference between a cappella music and regular music. That's no weddings, no music. You can't cut your hair. This for women applies only to the hair on the head. A woman is allowed to tweeze or electrolysis or remove facial hair or a body hair during this time. Men are not allowed to shave, obviously. And finally, we don't make the bracha of Shehechiyanu during this time period. A bracha of Shehechiyanu is a bracha that you make on something that is valuable and important and precious. So, a person gets a new computer, a new laptop, a new car, a new shetel, something like that. A person makes a Shehechiyanu on it. However, if it's something that benefits you and other people, let's say you're in a family and you get a new car or you get a new air conditioner or a new furniture in your home, so then the bracha is not Shehechiyanu, the bracha is Hatov HaMeitiv. We say Baruch Hashem Elokeinu Melech HaMatov HaMeitiv, and that's mutter to make during this time period. In other words, it's only the bracha of Shehechiyanu that a person can't make. So you can't make a new purchase if it's something that only you are benefiting from. But if it's something that the family is benefiting from, so then at least until Rosh Chodesh, it's permissible to do. Okay, Mirtz Hashem, we should all daven for Klal Yisrael. Like I said, I'm trying to share the achrayas with all of us that we should feel, you know, every bracha that we say counts, every tefillah counts, every mitzvah, every piece of achdus, bein adam l'chaveiro, whatever we could do to help other people in this time. Fan, just finished with one last thought. Maybe I'll, you know, show you Mevaseret Zion in the distance while we're talking about this. But, you know, my wife said this last night. You know, she said, you know, for all those weeks that everybody in Klal Yisrael was davening, you know, davening for the safe return of these boys. And, you know, and now we see what was coming up right after that. So Hashem, Shem Emet Hashem, take all of those tefillos that were heard then and save Klal Yisrael, protect Klal Yisrael. And Hine, show me Yisrael, lo yanum velo yishan, Hashem doesn't sleep. He's always protecting us. Okay, Mirtz Hashem, have a good Shabbos. We should hear Besuras Tovos Bekarov.